Hello guys, welcome back to our project number two video tutorial. And in this, we're going to talk about what are the basic things that you need in order to design this multi-vendor app as you see. Now, I've talked about the introduction to this and what this project entails in the previous video. So you can actually watch that to understand what you're about to do. Now, we need actually the four basic things and I have listed them here. The first one is we need a database. Now this database comprises of database and the database tables. So that's the first one. Now the second one is after creating a database table, we need our edu.net entity data model. That is what you're going to use to join the tables or to add the tables from the database to application in the Visual Studio. Now once you are done, we need to create our two controllers. That is the admin controller and user controller. Now, when you create these controllers, we must create the respective views for them. And these are the things that you're going to be using in our project. Okay, so these are the four key things that you need to know. So keep them and I will start. What you're going to talk about today first is going to be a database. So we're going to create a database table. Now, if you actually check here, we're going to create about four or five database tables. Now, we need to first create a database. Aside from that, we create our tables. So I have a script here to create a table, a database, and as you can see from here, we need to create a database table. So let me change this to SQL. Okay, so check here. Now what you are doing here first, you are creating a database table. Now so first we need to create a database. So we're going to use create database. So the name of database is going to be what? DB marketing. So you copy this and you add this go. So copy this and in your database management, you're going to paste this. So let me just clear everything. You're going to paste this here. So I'm going to create database. The name is DB marketing. Okay. So that's the name, then add go. So run this to create database. Now you see, when you check my database, I have created it already. So I need not to run this code again because I have it already. As you can see from here, that's a DB marketing that is over here. So create the database table. So that's the database. When you're done with this, you can decide to select here the database that you have created, or we can actually pass in this. Use DB marketing. So this DB marketing here, that is the name of the database. So we can pass in this, use DB marketing. So this means that it's going to use this, or it's going to set this as a current database, or you can decide to just click on this drop down to just select from here. So if you actually check here, you can see I have sample of databases here, and this is what I have created now, and that's what you've been using. So aside from creating database, so now you have a database. Now it are left with the tables. So let's go in there and create table. Now you know for admin has to sign in. He has to also sign up, isn't it? After signing up, admin has to create categories. And after creating the categories, the admin can delete the category or he can just create it. Now after creating, user can just create post ad. Okay, and select a category. The user has to sign up. The user can view the category. The user can view the ad, including the posted ad, as you saw in the introduction. So these are the table that you're going to be using. So I have the table list here. Now the first thing is I'm going to create a user table. So this is going to be an admin table. So let's copy this. Now if you check here, we are creating create table. This is for administration, right? Administrator. So create table TBL admin, and you're going to need three columns. We need the ID, and the ID is going to be identity, as also primary key as well. So this means that you're not going to provide any number for the ID. You're going to provide the values for username and password for the admin. Okay, so that is what you're going to just do. Now let's copy this. So copy this and in your management studio, let's paste this here. So run this to create your admin table. So you must have TBL admin, as I have here. So this I have my database table, because I have TBL admin. You must have the same. Now once you are done, let's say you're having username and password, and now the username is supposed to be unique. Password shouldn't supposed to be null as well. Other time they must get values, and it's supposed to be unique. You can't have two separate names, username which look similar or the same. No. Once you're done, you can decide to insert a sample value. So this is what you're actually inserting as a sample value, so we can actually use to test application. But you're going to create a sign up to actually sign up or to sign up a user to the application, and that's going to be an admin. So admin user. So let's copy this and let's run this in application to insert a sample data into the table that we created. That's a TBL admin. So we have this. Okay. So run this, and now when you run that, you can actually make a query from the table. So select star from TBL, that is admin. So select star from this admin and see. So you can see we have the various names over here, as you can see from there. Now once you are done with this, the next thing to do here is we're going to create a category table, because after the user has now signed in, you can just sign up. And now we're going to use the same table, because when the user signs up, it's going to be in this TBL admin. Okay, and now we can now check from this and let the person in. So we need to create a category table. And now if you check here, this is the name of the category as TBL category. We have in a category ID as identity, primary key. We have a category name, unique, category image, category status, and we have category foreign key to the admin. So you know that since you're going to create a multi-vendor, you may have 10, 100,000 of more users or vendors there. And now each vendor must have a link to his or her product, categories and products, right? So we have to link them together. You have to create a relationship between the tables so that you can actually retrieve the values or the columns or the rows for a particular user. So we create category, and now we are linking this category to the admin. Okay, so this means that the admin has the right to create this category. So that's why we create category foreign key admin. Then we reference the TBL admin as administrator ID as this first column at ad.what.id here. So we can actually just copy this and now also paste this in our project. So paste this here. So then run this to create the application. Okay. So create this table. Now aside from creating this table, the next thing to do here is you're going to create a user. So now we are done with the administrator. Because the administrator is supposed to log in or sign up, and I'm supposed to create category, and that's all. Now the rest is left to the user. So we have to create user account. So that's the way to create user account. We are creating user ID, username, email, password, image, and contact. So we have ID name, as you can see, identity, and we have name, not null, email supposed to be unique, password and contact supposed to also be unique. So we can actually copy the whole this, and now let's paste this here to create the user. So we have the user table. Now once you are done, the next thing to do here is we're going to create a product. So let's create product. So you're going to have a product ID, product name, product image, product price, product description, and you're going to have a foreign key for category and a foreign key for user. So we are linking from the user. The user has what? The product. So as soon as you pick in a user ID as one, you go to the user and reference ID as one, that is which person is that, and you're going to know the type of product the person holds in your application. So that's why you have to link product for foreign key and product for category. So which category does the person hold, which product, or which, who is that person, who is the user? Okay, and since this is a product, you're going to link them together. So when you pick a user, you may know the category that his products are found. We may also know the product that belongs to that exact person. So we're going to have this TBL product being added to the database table. Okay, so once you are done, I learned that is the end of the database itself. Now, so if you actually make a search here to see, you must have three tables, and that you must have for TBL product, you must have TBL user, maybe myself, TB our category, and TB admin, that is 4 tables here, I think so. So once you are done, then this is what you're going to do. Now in the last, in this the last end, go to click on your database, open, click on database diagram. Okay, so there's a diagram here. Now right click and go to new database diagram, and now you can see we have 4 tables here. So select all the 4 tables and now go to add. Now wait for the relationship to be created, and as you can see from here, we have the relationship now. Now a user has a route to product. Okay, now this product has a route to category, because this product is going to depend on this category, and this category is going to depend on the admin, because the admin is going to create a category. After creating, user can now create product using this category. So this is the diagram, and you have to actually enable that. Alright, so that is it for the database. So this database, we've talked about how to create it, and we have the scripts to create all the database and the tables as well over here. Our next meeting talk about how to add an ADO.NET data model to our project, and I will start developing our website or our web application as well. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this is clear and it is understandable. I'm going to see you in the next video.